हेलो एवरीवन, क्लास नाइन्थ। आई एम राशिद खान फ्रॉम लक्ष्मी प्रसाद मेमोरियल पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। क्लास हियर टुडे विल हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर, इन विच आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन सम टॉपिक्स। सो हियर इज अ टॉपिक गिवेन एज मिक्सचर। टुडे ऑन मिक्सचर वी हैव टू डिस्कस to which we can say it is a mixture. Mixture is also the combination of the mixture forms when two or more compounds are mixed together, but they are not mixed chemically. That means they are not combined chemically. So mixture are the substances that are formed when two or more than two types of atom and molecules combine, but the condition is they are not chemically combined to one another. So the such type of a substances that has atoms and molecules in its compositions, but the composition is not chemically bonded. That means these two atom or molecule are not combined to one another by a chemically bond or chemical bonding. So that type of particular substance is said to be the mixture. As we know, the milk is a mixture. Why? Because there is some atom and molecules by which they can be form, but they are not chemically binded to one another. Here we can say in the milk there is there is a protein, fats, water, cream, etc. are added or found in them, sugar. So that we can say these are the type of mixture of these substances, or these component has to form the milk. So milk is what actually, so we can say it is a type of mixture. Why it is having most type of minerals, vitamins, protein, fats, cream, sugar, water, etc. Why? Because it is said to be what? It is a mixture. Next one is the mixture is another form like a swirl. Swirl is another form of a mixture. Why? Because it can contain water, air, soil particles, type of a soils, minerals, humus, etc. These are the different forms of the atom and molecules, and this can be said because it can contain different type of a component in it, and they are not chemically combined to one another. So that is another form of what actually this is a mixture. It is also a form of mixture. The oil globules, the fat globules is another form of a mixture. Why? Because there you can see the different forms of components of a matter. Components are the substances that are not chemically combined, so they are the form of a mixture. Here we can say the mixture is what actually it is the different constituent, or we can say the different type of a substances when added to one another, that are said to be the mixture. Or it is also called as a components of mixture, like air, glucose, salt solution, sugar solution, seawater, ink, petrol, petroleum, the brass, salt solution, paint, lime water. There are varieties of the mixture, you can see the chalk water, nemolite water, the fluor in water, the sand in water, the milk of magnesia, butter, cheese, cream, shaving cream. There are the number of a product we can say. This is all about the mixture. Why? Because these are the different type of a mixture having their different compositions. So we can say on the basis of the compositions, the mixture are of two important types. What are these actually? These are the homogeneous and as well as heterogeneous. So what does it mean about that, the homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture? So we will discuss about types of mixture. We can say that types of mixture, homogeneous mixture, this is homogeneous, and here is heterogeneous. It is a homogeneous mixture and it is a heterogeneous mixture. So on the basis of the property they can have, on that basis we can say this is the homogeneous and that is the heterogeneous. Why? Because homo is defined as, homo means same, and hetero denoted as different or various. So it is a form of same kind of a components. When in their any mixture, when the substances or the particles of matter are same type, or you can say the partially distributed, or the distribution of a particles uniform in any mixture, the such type of a mixture are said to be the homogeneous mixture. What we can say, in the homogeneous mixture the components are distributed in all over the solution in a same manner. That is what we can call it is a homogeneous mixture. We can say those mixture in which there is, this is the mixture which in which the substances completely mixed together, are the homogeneous mixture, are the type of a mixture in which the different type of a substances get mixed completely to one another. Why? Because it is called as homogeneous mixture, or it is also called as the indigenous mixture. It can be distinguished by from one another. That is what, why? Because it is called as homogeneous. Homogeneous, same type of components if it is found all over the mixture, or the particles are continuously uniformly distributed in all over the mixture, the such type of a mixture are said to be what, they are homogeneous mixture. On the basis of the homogeneity, you can say all the homogeneous mixtures are of solution. Why? Because the solutions are those particular type of a substance in which all the matter are distributed completely in all components. That means in all their whole amount. So they may be completely dissolved, or they may be completely to mix one mixed with one another. The particles are uniformly distributed. So thus, the such type of a mixture are called as homogeneous mixture. We know very well homogeneous mixture are different type of a mixture. Like we can say here is a homogeneous mixture in case of a salt solution, in case of a copper sulfate solution, in case of a copper in case of a ferrous sulfate solution, alcohol, water mixes, petroleum and their mixtures, soda water, soft drink and lemonade, vinyl chloride, brass, air, kerosene, oil and petroleum. So these such type of mixture are said to be the homogeneous mixture. Why? Because they are called as homogeneous because their distribution, this is in the components of a mixture, there is a not a single component is a particular place. Why? Because it can be uniformly distributed all over its content. So that one is the reason why, because the particles are distributed all over the content in a uniformly manner. So this type of a mixture are said to be the homogeneous mixture. Now heterogeneous mixture. What we can say the heterogeneous mixture? A mixture containing a type of a mixture in which there is a two or more immiscible liquids are interacted to one another. Why? Because it is called as heterogeneous mixture. That means the particles in it are not uniformly distributed all over the component and over the contents. So we can say a type of a mixture in which the components of the substances are the components are not distributed, or particles are not distributed equally, or they could not be distributed all over the component, all over the content uniformly formed. So that one is called as a heterogeneous mixture. You can say that heterogeneous mixture is a type of a mixture in which the particles are not distributed in all over their contents. The particles that are not equally distributed over into the complete components, so that type of a mixture is said to be the heterogeneous mixture. What are the different example of a heterogeneous mixture? You could know about glass, coal, soil, wood, iron filling, sulfur, mixture dyes, the shaving cream, chalk powder, star solution, source solution, iron fillings, the milk of magnesia, butter, etc. These are the different forms of the heterogeneous mixture. So this is all about that the heterogeneous mixture. We could know about the two type on the basis of the heterogeneity and homogeneity. We could explain about if there is a mixture called ferric or ferrous sulfate with iron. So the ferrous sulfate when added to the iron, this will form a mixture, but their composition are quite different from one another. Why? Because the ferrous and iron can be separated. If the ferrous and iron can be separated, So here is the mixture of iron and ferrous. So this could be easily iron filling and sulfur, that is ferrous. So this could be easily distinguishes or separated from one another by the process called the separating method. By the magnet, by using the magnet, we can separate the iron and the remaining part of the mixture of ferrous is remaining over there. So that particular type of a metal remains same in the form of a heterogeneous mixture. So it is a type of a heterogeneous mixture in which sulfur can be separated by using the magnet, and this is the way by which we can know about the heterogeneous mixture. In this heterogeneous mixture, two type of a different components, they can be added to one another and they will form the mixture, but they are separated from a very simple simple procedure, and through which we can say this is all about the heterogeneous mixture. So it is all about today's lecture. We will discuss to the next day. Thank you for being